Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ESL 1 2014, our Cologne stop, the third major for Counter-Strike Global Offensive, live from Gamescom 2014. Day three here, about to get underway with the quarterfinals. We've already had two phenomenal days of Counter-Strike with some great games. If you haven't checked them out, go and check out Cloud9 versus Titan from day one. It also set a brand new record for the most viewers that we've ever had watching Counter-Strike in the world. 272,000 of you tuning in just to watch Counter-Strike. Absolutely fantastic. Hopefully today we can beat that as we head into our quarterfinals. First, let's look back though at the 16 teams that qualified. We had teams from all over the world this time. It was fantastic to have the Indian team here. Also, Vox Eminov from Australia joining in. Sadly, neither of them able to get out of very difficult groups. And for the second consecutive major in a row, Titan falling in the group stages once more. We do, however, have eight amazing teams through to the quarterfinals. We were discussing it backstage just now, and we just can't call it. Every single game could go either way. These are your quarterfinalists in order. We'll start off with Fnatic versus Na'Vi, and we'll play all four quarterfinals today, and tomorrow we'll move on to the semifinals and the grand final to crown our $250,000 tournament with the third major championship. The previous two winners are still in the mix. They're already in there. NIP, who have won pretty much everything except for one of the majors, are also in contention as well. Let's introduce our first two teams to the stage. Our first team are, of course, one of those major winners, winning at DreamHack last year, attempting to become the first team to win two. Please welcome Fnatic. And they go head-to-head with another legendary Counter-Strike team, a team that have many disciplines all over the world across esports, but are most famed for the success that they had in Counter-Strike 1.6. Back to do battle again under the Na'Vi brand here in the third major of the year. Please welcome Na'Vi! We'll shortly be getting underway in our first quarterfinal, but first let's catch up with our analysis desk, ably hosted today by Mr. Sir Scoots.
Thank you very much, Red Eye. As always, great to have you on the big stage. I tried to be Red Eye. I don't think I did so well yesterday. That's a tough job, actually.
I was reading some threads about it. Yeah, you did do too well.
Fix you on the fly here.
Thank you, brother.
You're welcome. Yeah, so obviously we have our fancy desk again. Nice to see you, Richard Lewis, as always.
Great to be here.
Always having to, you know, show me up with the fancy tie.
Well, I did just come from a court appearance for crimes against Counter-Strike, so.
Nice. More importantly, forget about us. We have our true expert. How are you, Top Gun?
Good, thank you. Good to be here. Good to be on board with you guys, and looking forward to some big games ahead.
And obviously, if you don't know who Top Gun is, he is the enforcer on Vox Seminar. Show him the guns. Show him the gun show.
Yeah, get the guns, bro. No guns.
Posh is not the only one
later
with the guns, right?
Later at night.
So, yeah. So let's get right into it. Obviously, kind of Red Eye set up the day. Mm-hmm. We've got eight teams left. Every team that's left is on that HalfLifeTV.org ranked list.
Yeah.
Like, no real surprises. Obviously, a couple other teams got upset to get in here, but every team that made it through kind of ranked, kind of a good team.
Oh, well, look, I mean, there was some very obviously deficient teams that were there in the groups. I don't want to say this too loudly because he's right next to me, but I think we looked at the Australians and the Indians, perhaps being the guys that were maybe going to have to sort of drop out. And then the rest of it, there were some interesting groups, I felt, where it was a bit of a lottery. You couldn't really tell. I mean, the Cloud9 group was so stacked. And for them to get through was a huge achievement. I had a feeling they were maybe going to do it. They're on this real crest of a wave. They're performing incredibly well in North America. But I still think it's a huge achievement and great for the tournament that we've managed to keep that global feel. We haven't just whittled it down to being an entirely European selection. You've still got some boys in there. So.
Yeah, and again, like, not going to be biased about it. I didn't necessarily expect them to do so well. Maybe get out of that group, although they had a very tough group. But, like, they've had some great matches.
Well,
again,
yeah.
Very close. And again, all these teams, those that won and lost, best of ones we know are very much a hit or miss, especially with some of the new maps. And again, you get no time to recover. It's one map, you know, and if you're slow to warm up, you're going to be out. What are your thoughts so far, you know, how we got to yesterday, and who's surprised Absolutely. You, who has not surprised you?
Look, no surprises. I mean, it's at this level of the game, you know, anyone can win. The beautiful thing about Counter-Strike is, you know, on any given day, you know, depending on how the teams perform, like you said, Cloud9, absolutely fantastic job. We were hoping to verse them. They were in our group. But, you know, luckily or unluckily for us, we didn't have to verse them. And, you know, ultimately it didn't make a difference. But at this point, you know, any team can win this comp. Any team can take out the competition. It comes down to, you know, the star players being exactly that, starring for their team, for their country, whatever you want to call it. And, you know, I'm sure all the players are feeling the pressure. They know every game's a tough game, and pretty much every game is a final from this point on.
Now, yesterday, last night's result made you kind of smile a little bit. Walk me through that a little
look,
bit.
Look, we got 16-1. Yeah? There's no beating around the bush. It hurts. It hurts big time. Against Titan, fantastic team on Nuke. We started T-side first, obviously, you know, tough mountain to climb. We got pumped. It is what it is. And then they versed Dignitas. So they got 16-1. So obviously we feel a little bit better, although maybe that should make us feel worse. But it's, you know, it's hard to say. At the end of the day, you know, the better teams got through. They deserved it. And, you know, good luck to them for the rest of the tournament.
Yep. And our first matchup today, obviously, as Paul alluded to, Fnatic versus Navi. Number 11 in the world, taking on number 3. But again, the number 3 team, Navi, coming out second seed in their group. Fnatic coming out first seed.
Yeah, I got to say, I wouldn't put too much stock in the rankings now that we're here. Yeah. We've had some warm-up tournaments. People have been playing online in Star Ladder. We had Gfinity just before this. And we got a good look at that Fnatic team there. And they're not 8 places between this Navi side. That's a little bit false. I think the ranking doesn't really do them justice, because not only have they looked very solid here with some great results, they look good at Gfinity. I mean, they kind of fell when the big questions were asked of them, but they looked very convincing. They overcome some tough tests, like against Mouseports, where they went to overtime to win that finally in the final third map. They went to a 3-map decider with them. So they're still feeling each other out. They're a new team. I think they've played less than 20 maps together. So for them to do as well as they have, I mean, they're getting better all the time. Na'Vi are the experienced and, you know, seasoned campaigners. So this is going to be a great sort of combination of a new team that's on the ascendancy and the sort of status quo. Are they going to be able to live up to their past billing?
Yep. Thoughts on the matchup?
You know, I'm a bit biased, like you are maybe towards Cloud9. I want Fnatic to win this. I want them to win it convincingly. Unlikely it's going to happen. You know, anything can happen, really. I'm excited. It's going to be big games, big plays. Excited for, you know, good Counter-Strike to be played. And with what he said, Na'Vi are more, you know, used to one another, I guess you could say. Whereas, you know, this team is still gelling, still bonding, and hopefully they do well.
And what you're alluding to, your bias, which a lot of people maybe who are new to the Fnatic brand don't realize, but it's actually an Australian-based company. Yep. The owners are Australian. Obviously, they operate out of London now, so kind of a home flag. Obviously, the players aren't Australian, but so that's kind of nice that you still have it it in your heart. All right, well, we are pretty much wrapped. The players are ready. Our caches are ready. The caches are why we walk you through what maps, like they did yesterday. Obviously, slightly different system. Pick one, ban one, pick one, ban one, pick one. So then we've got our two maps set. We are in best of 3. The rest of the maps fall into that rotating random system for the final map. So we could see some overpass cobblestone decider maps.
I almost think certainly we will. I've been obviously putting together the stats just before, quickly trying to compile some numbers. And Na'Vi have played in their last however many games, I think it is a grand total of 15. They've only really played 3 maps on rotation, and then Mirage, Dust 2, and Inferno. They've predominantly played Mirage. They've played it 7 times, but they've only won 3, and yet they keep playing it in the Star Ladder series. They've obviously got a feeling that they can do something on it tactically, but we're not really seeing that consistently. So the map that Fnatic need to avoid is Dust 2. They've got to avoid it because they've only had 2 wins out of the last 5. They did beat Nip at Gfinity, but everyone did. Do you know what I mean? I think I could have put a team together and maybe beat Nip at that particular event. So I think Dust 2 is a very weak map for them. Conversely, Na'Vi have struggled on Inferno, and Fnatic are dominant on Inferno with 3 wins from 3, having beat Titan, Mouse, and Epsilon.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen. And we'll be back between every single map, so don't worry. We'll break down each map as we get to it. But, you know, once again, the Room on Fire guys, Anders and Semler, take it away.
Thank you, Scoots, honorary member of Room on Fire, handling the analyst desk with Richard Lewis. So glad that we have these guys, and Top Gun too. So it's really cool that we have that desk now today. We're taking steps here at ESL. We're getting things rolling for the quarterfinals. Yeah.
It's almost like it was planned ahead, right? Slowly ramping it up. Now we're adding people like Richard Lewis as well. We got pro players. We got Toshpot here later. We got Pansy as well. And we got Red Eye on the stage. It could not possibly get any better, except for the fact that we also have some incredible games, starting with this one, Semler.
Oh, yeah, man. Fnatic versus Na'Vi. This has actually been one hell of a mix. But Na'Vi, as I said, you know, they kind of touched on this at the analysis desk, but Na'Vi taking second seed in their group. This has been kind of the story throughout the groups. We've had teams that we really expected to get first seed, and they couldn't quite do it. But okay, now, enough of that. Let's actually get into what we're going to see here in this next, because the Scoots kind of said this just a moment ago. It's actually going to be a different format here. Now that it's best of three, each team only gets one ban, and then they have to pick a map, and then the remaining three get randomed.
Yeah, so Mirage is out. Fnatic saying, we're not going to play the best team in the whole world on their own best map. So that's not good enough. Cobblestone is going to be gone as well, which is, I think, a smart choice from Na'Vi. Not putting any kind of mix out there. And now we're in the picking stage.
Yeah, this is where it gets really interesting. Okay, it looks like JW's the one taking care of that here for Fnatic. No surprise that Na'Vi want to get rid of Cobblestone, but it will be Inferno. First pick, Inferno. Now we get to see exactly what Na'Vi are going to go for. It looks like they get to actually pick out which side they get to start on.
Yeah, so Fnatic picked the map, Na'Vi picked the side. On Inferno, maybe not such a big deal, but, you know, we're talking about tiny, tiny margins. Maybe it will be a factor anyway. And Dust 2 for the second map, and as Richard Lewis said, that could be a really scary map for Fnatic.
Oh, man, this is really scary, but though, last map could be Nuke. Nuke is still in this pool right now.
Well,
Na'Vi risking it. Oh, man.
Nuke was chosen at random. There it is. So Na'Vi, historically speaking, the old lineup anyway, with that it featured Markulov as well, was never, ever, ever going to play Nuke. They just never did it. And obviously, we have the same leaders
in
this
game. Look at Garden. He's facepalming. Like, this is worst case scenario time here.
So now the question is Na'Vi just going to make up their minds to do this 2-0 and just say, well, we're not even going to get to Nuke? It can happen. Na'Vi are not bad at playing Inferno, but I do think Fnatic have the edge on that map. It's going to basically require a monster performance from Na'Vi to avoid ending up on Nuke. This has happened once before in Na'Vi's history in Global Offensive, and that was the SLTV Star Series Final. They coin flip and it ended on Nuke, and they got utterly destroyed on it.
Utterly destroyed.
That was before Guardian joined.
Man, God, look at them all. This is a real... Unreal. Now we actually have to see a 2-0 here. We have to see a 2-0, basically, if Na'Vi want to take this.
Well,
I mean, Fnatic, we know that Fnatic have put some work in on Nuke, and that was with the old lineup, but still, they actually have put some work into it, so it's definitely going to be formidable on that map.
I was about to say, let's not get completely out of control. There is another team that we've basically said will always veto Nuke out, and that's virtus.pro, and then at Gfinity, they showed up and won the whole tournament on Nuke against Titan. So, let's not take everything for granted here. There's $250,000 prize pool. I guess they do have some tricks up their sleeves after all, and we're going to have to find out how this all unfolds. They are getting ready and talking everything out.
Well, one thing that we do know is that Na'Vi, I mean, they speak about their boot camp. They have been training going into this tournament. Could be that they really have been putting time into the match, making sure that, well, they understand the veto system. Now we've actually had some time going into this, the warning there, but have they had enough time to develop strategies on all the maps? I mean, seven maps in the pool, that's quite a bit. So we have to see if Na'Vi are going to be up to snuff. Coach Devilwalk now really just pepping up his players, making sure that they're all on the same page. It was a bit wishy-washy for Fnatic, actually, last night. A couple of them not really getting too much sleep. The nerves playing a little bit here, but we have to see if they're going to be able to bounce back and really just have that strong performance right out the gate, because Inferno is going to be crucial for either one of these teams. Fnatic need Inferno, and now we have to see them really get into it.
Yeah, they do look pumped up, and I like the fact, I just like seeing Devil being in charge.
Yeah.
And listen up, guys, listen to me now. And
that's always been it. That's how it's always been. Like, he's the perfect coach for that team because they have always looked to him for guidance.
Yeah.
So Devilwalk really fitting into that role. He's the one who's going to be there to make sure that the team gel and make sure that they play together. And Pronax, of course, is going to be making the calls. But now we have to see how Na'Vi are going to get into it. Na'Vi, of course, always with the huddle before the matches. The team spirit is there. Then we can hear them from here.
Na'Vi is a LAN team. This is really where they do their absolute finest work, and I would not underestimate them in this matchup. That would be a huge mistake, I imagine. Starting on the CT side as well is what they're going to be doing here on Inferno. Do you think, Semler? Who do you see winning this whole best of three? Now we know the maps, we know what signs they start on. Mm. What's happening here?
I think Fnatic are going to be hard-pressed here in this first half. Na'Vi, I mean, the last time, the map that really stands out is the one, obviously, that was played online versus iVPower, right, where we just saw Na'Vi never really show up on Inferno, but this is different. This is a totally different beast. Now we're into best of three territory. Now we're on land. We can expect the big plays from Na'Vi here. Edward played out of his mind on that map in particular, but Na'Vi are just very good on the CT side, and the fact that they get to pick it and have the easier half to start this best of three off on, I think that's huge for them. That's a big advantage going into this, because they can afford to give away a couple rounds warming up, whereas Fnatic are going to be under pressure. Fnatic need that strong start, need to get the pistol, need to get a couple rounds on the board before they can start really feeling comfortable here.
Now, yesterday when we saw Na'Vi play on this map, actually I think that their most impressive performance was their terrorist side, because they did that slow style, they crept up on the bomb sides. I think we managed to coin the term the Na'Vi constrictor, because it seemed like they were just slowly creeping in and choking the life out of the opponents. But then came the CT side. In spite of Guardian having a great match on Inferno, he missed some very important shots, and that cannot happen today.
That's true, they did actually struggle with that in Guardian. Definitely, but Guardian, he seems just to be very very zen right now. He came over to talk a little bit while the teams were back here before they went out on the stage, and he seems very calm, cool, collected. And I mean, the thing is that if they're laughing right now, that's great. Like, if they're laughing, they're joking, they're getting pepped up, that's what it's about right now. They need to be in the right state of mind. But the warm-up countdown has begun. We are now 50 seconds away from starting our first map in the quarterfinals. And it's a real thing of beauty, this quarterfinals. Every team that we expected to get through practically has done it. Top two seeds in all of the groups. Maybe not in the seeds we expected. Perhaps, you know, they have changed places with Na'Vi taking second seed, for example, in their group. But still, they've made it through. So these quarterfinals are going to be a thing of beauty.
And that is exactly right. Again, as we have the last 30 seconds here, remember, guys, if you are out on the stream watching, you can tweet at us. That's hashtag ESL1 to get on the Twitter feed as well. So definitely don't forget about that either. And it's at ESL1, or sorry, at ESLCS for the ESL Counter-Strike Twitter right there.
Well, I really like that. Another thing is that now these teams have had experience up on the stage. They know what to expect. You know, they're already talking about figuring out the spacing between the players. Just the little details. You may not think that this means a lot, but if you feel a little bit crowded on that stage, right, you may not play up to snuff. But all the players now know what to expect on this stage. They're going to be having the right setups for themselves. They're going to have all the room. So everything can go right here for either team. Na'Vi, Fnatic, 6 seconds away, and we get into the crucial pistol round here. Fnatic going with 4 Kevlar as well, a flash and a smoke, so it seems like they've got really something in mind. Double kit pickup, actually, for Na'Vi. That's not something we see too often. No. We usually see only one guy going for the kit, because that costs $400. That's 2 flashbangs, a smoke grenade, that you are willing to go into and actually just say, well, if they plant the bomb, we want to make pretty damn sure we're going to be able to defuse it.
Actually, almost to the point where I'm wondering if that's a bit of a mistake, because I think that's really important, because retaking a bomb site with a kit is obviously really great, but having 2 flashbangs to retake away could be even better. Seuss is up in the bear room, and Krims is gonna walk in instant death. And on the crossfire, they do have Edward waiting there. Good damage from Pronax. Can you do a little bit more? And there's Seuss going down, so it's an even start.
Oh, and it's a great start that they managed to drop Edward so low as well. That's really gonna put him on the back foot. Make sure he has to play very safe here. But Fnatic, it's a quick 1-for-1 trade. They have done more damage to Na'Vi, and we still see Flush on JW kind of floating around in Banana, trying to draw out Starik, see if they can't get anything done here. But it does look like it's shaping up for an A play in the end. 45 seconds left on this clock, and we have Fnatic setting up now. Pronax with that one smoke that he bought at the beginning of the round. It's out, and it's going to land to block off Pit.
Perfectly right in the window of that truck. And that's going to be a problem for Edward down there. He's not going to be able to help out as much as you'd like. Guardian has to hit some great headshots here. And there's the one. Needs a little bit more, but JW will put an end to it. Edward almost gets the kill on Olofmeister. Now it's a 2-on-2, and JW takes down Seized. Now Starik's 1-on-2 retake. There's no bomb plant. Just now it's happening, so he has time.
He has time. And there's 2 kits to pick up somewhere on this site, so he should be able to have a bit of time to play around here. JW is the only man with full HP. He's got 2 kills. Olofmeister down to 2 HP, and one click would do it if Starks could just find the shot, but he's getting played down perfectly here by Fnatic. They're playing the angles, and they get him through the box. You can now spam through there. And that is the triple kill for JW, and that is the strong start now for Fnatic. They get that pistol round.
Very nicely done. That actually looked like it was going to get completely out of control. The second kill that JW got inside the bomb site before he put the bomb down, that was really, really important. If he hadn't got that kill, I think, and if he hadn't got it as fast as he did, that would have been a big problem for them. So nice start, but Na'Vi replying with armor and even a Mag 7 on Seized. And this Deagle on Guardian, yesterday actually he hit some really good 1 Deagle, so gotta be a little bit worried here.
If anybody's capable, I mean, we have Guardian here in the foreground and the camera for Na'Vi. You can see him at work, the master.
Yeah, but if they go B, there's a Mag 7 waiting, and that's, you can't really underestimate that either. Seized waiting by that orange box, and that's gonna be taking down one. Fnatic need to commit off all back, and they will take down Seized, but standing still is, that's not a good idea.
Yeah, Seized actually getting a little bit ahead of himself there. They decide to swap out because one of them had a pump action shotgun. Flush is gonna actually trade up and pick up a Galil here, so three rifles, and it's a quick one-for-one again on the B site. This is gonna open up, though. Zeus with the CZ gets 2 kills! Big frags there, and Na'Vi, they're on the brink of turning it around in the second round of this first half. This would be calamitous if Fnatic let it go.
Yeah, the CZ 75 upset has been happening all tournament, and even before the tournament, I think everyone who knew anything was calling it out and saying, look, this pistol is just maybe a little bit too powerful. It's a nice spot there from Olofmeister. That gives them the bomb plan, and he can still win this. So very, very smooth work. And Olofmeister has been a rock on Fnatic in this tournament so far. I think actually Fnatic want a chance of making it through here against Na'Vi. It's going to be in large part down to Olofmeister. Yeah,
no doubt about it. Definitely the strongest player on the team. And we saw that yesterday versus VP on Overpass as well. Top frag for Fnatic, but Guardian comes through with the Deagle. Not the Juan Deagle, but still, it gets the job done. Olofmeister is gone, and Na'Vi will take the second round here. They turn it around. Fnatic falling to the anti-eco CZ curse.
Yeah, it's been happening. I mean, I'm almost about to say that it's been happening so much, at least teams are used to it now. Yeah. Because before the CZ, it was really sort of big, you know, almost shocking if somebody lost, you know, the anti-eco. The right. P250 and the 5.7 are still good pistols, but it was still not really sort of, you know, such a you know, normal occurrence.
Well, you're sweating buckets walking around on this map just waiting for some guy to jump around a corner and mow down half your team. And I mean, there isn't a whole lot you can do to react as well. This is the thing, you know, we put a lot of emphasis on the anti-ecos, but sometimes really, you know, that's gonna make the difference. They just get that angle on you and you're done. And that just happened. Zeus with those 2 big kills pretty much gave it up there for Na'Vi. It is gonna be the mow down now as Fnatic try rushing out through apartments onto short, but the crossfire is perfect for Na'Vi. Zeus, Edward, Guardian all getting a piece.
Yeah, looking quite strong there. I mean, that's really important, you know, just picking up all those rounds and making sure they don't throw anything away. And now Fnatic are gonna be able to buy again. And we'll see.
Now, exactly. Well, the big thing here is that Fnatic, they're willing to just not give away too many rounds to Na'Vi, not allow Na'Vi to start getting too much money on their side. They want to make sure that they can keep the pressure going because they lost that second round. They need to make sure that they can get at least a couple more here early on in the half before things may get out of control for Na'Vi. So limited nades, but they still all pick up AKs. And everybody here on Fnatic capable. Olofmeister, Krims, the 2 guys who played out of their minds yesterday to put Fnatic through first seed in that final deciding match. We have to see them come in big here again, and they do very well on Inferno. Edward with the 1-for-1. Krims takes him down, as I call his name.
And Krims almost fell as well. That could have been a quick double kill for Edward. That would have been an awful start. C's going to be walking out towards Archway. Spots a couple of people, and they are going to hesitate, but Zeus goes down. Now, that A-bomb side is a lot weaker, and they're going to go for it. But Guardian with the headshot takes down Olofmeister. Is he going to flash in and peek again? He will, and almost gets a second kill there, and time is running out for Fnatic. They got to get in here and put the bomb down quick. This is taking way too long. C's has got into a much better position. He's going to be able to drop Flusher as well, and JW takes a run. 21 HP and 40 seconds. This is not going to be happening.
Masterful play by Seized, working his way onto that site, playing the angles so well, really just staying alive. Guardian in the pit, though, is the MVP, basically, in this round for Na'Vi so far. We have to see now if they get the proper read, because JW, he's taking his time getting to the site to try and make sure that Na'Vi think, oh, he may go B right now. We didn't have anybody mid. We didn't have anybody looking arch. He could have walked around us to get to that other site. Instead, he's waiting calmly to take advantage of the fact that they have rotated off. But look at Na'Vi's positioning. Seized, once again, he knows exactly what's up. He's looking there, and he should be able to pick him out, but Guardian will get the frag from short.
But I think you're exactly right, though, because in that position, the only way you're gonna win it is if the other team offer you some sort of mistake. So JW put himself in a position where if they had made a mistake, he could capitalize on it, and that's all he can do. There is no way to just say, I'm going to try and get three hot shots in 2 seconds and win the round. They have to do some sort of, they have to make an error before you can really get into the game again. And they didn't this time, they set it up perfectly.
Is Na'Vi really playing very solidly since they've turned it around? Second round win, but now seized. Not sure if it's a rush or not. You got to imagine the control here. You know, he's not even throwing that smoke. He didn't hear footsteps following him, so he's like, okay, are they coming or not? I'm going to hold on to this smoke to make sure I can burn a little bit more time off this clock.
Yeah, but that's still scary. If you're wrong and they just turn the corner with the C-set in hand,
you're dead.
You are dead.
Sometimes it does comes down to intuition, you know, the gut feeling for these players. And well, seized is definitely one of the best. And he is one of the guys that we need to look towards for Na'Vi.
Molotov is down. They're running into it. They might end up burning alive here. Starix picking up a good double kill. And his eco round is not going to be working out. Great quad kill from Starix. Really making it work. So, yeah, the fish are going to be safe for another round somewhere.
Yeah, they are. And the aqua chicken as well, man. Yeah. You don't have to worry about them.
Na'Vi is, you know, they have the fish at heart here.
Well, they're people, you know, they're animal people, right? They're like Freiburg, you know,
Freiburg, he smashed that flyer Dreamhack. Yeah, I still wake up screaming at night,
person,
thinking about it.
I just think about his lilies. What was it? I still think about that interview where he's like, yeah, my lilies have died 4 times.
Poor Freiburg.
Poor Freiburg. I mean, he tries, and he looks it, but not meant to be, Freiburg. You're a killer at heart.
And in the game too yesterday, God, Freiburg played well. But now, Flusher actually already taking a bit of damage. He's down to 14 points of health, and that's all through the smoke. So Starix finding the superior angle. This is a dangerous game to play for both sides, because it could have just as well gone the other way. And if you do fail on the CT side to do it, it is really a big problem. So I'm not always a fan of this shooting through, but Flusher, he came out short this time.
That's a lot of damage taken, actually. That's pretty much the clear win for Na'Vi. It seems like Fnatic wants to set up for a smoke round going on to A site. We already have the one blocking off library, so that's going to be Guardian's position. Smoked off. Not a whole lot he can do apart from put shots through, but this time around, Fnatic are doing a much better job. Zeus in position at Arch, taking the fight with Pronax, but so far, Fnatic are getting bogged down. They've used a lot of their nades to try and make this happen, and Na'Vi are holding for now.
God, Zeus is playing well on this map right now, which is not normally the guy we look for to top frag or anything like that. Krims with a really good headshot. Zeus picks up a double kill, and Edward's going to get taken down. Krims taking matters into his own hands.
But Zeus has dropped the bomb carrier. Flusher is stuck behind the pillar. He's got so little HP. Zeus trying to spray him down, but this is still a 2-on-3. He sees Will take the fight, and that's not going to work.
Oh, but they double peek him. Krims has got a quad kill in the round, and it's going to be a 1-on-1. Seized versus Olaf Meister. Bomb goes down with 8 seconds, and now Seized is going to come out. Olaf Meister, he has to clutch it. Can he clutch it? He smokes, puts out the smoke, tries to narrow the option that Seized has right here, and actually Seized can't see a thing. Creeping up, Olaf Meister looking at the edge, and Seized will pick up the kill. It's going to be a triple, and Na'Vi, they do it once again.
Seized. And look at how cool he is, man. He just reaches over for the slap with Edward there. This is a man we need to watch for Na'Vi, because since he's been picked up, Na'Vi have been so dangerous, so difficult to deal with, because he is a monster. He is their point man. Edward, Guardian, we look to them as the superstars as well. But Seize, since he's been added, has been consistently topping the scoreboard. And when he tops that scoreboard, Na'Vi are unstoppable. Fnatic have to find a way to deal with him.
5-1, Na'Vi are on the more favored side here, and we can't forget that, but Fnatic have lost 5 rounds in a row after winning the pistol, and it's starting to dig into them a little bit, but they're a professional team. They can absolutely bounce back. It's way too soon, I think, to start panicking here.
Well, Krims had a very nice entry onto that A side as well. Two very
Four
clean kills.
Kills in total.
Krims is a man to watch as well. And Flusha will find Guardian pushing down, trying to get aggressive with that AWP, but hey, guess what? Starks can op as well. If he finds a shot on JW, Swedes aren't going to be very pleased with that. Starks, in fact, had quite a long time actually opping for Na'Vi.
Yeah. We saw that in that one game on Dust 2. That was
still
great.
One of the sickest holds.
Edward going to be picking off Pronax in the middle. It was very unfortunate for Fnatic, because they were in a position where they were 4-on-4. And that's generally, when you trade evenly, generally going to favor the terrorist side, because it's the CTs that have to spread out their forces, and you can still hit one bomb site with the rest of your force. So little bit of a difference there. Starix flashed, and he's going to be falling back, and they can't catch him quick enough. He's going to smoke out as well. Oh, JW, great opening. Starix, too bold.
Yeah, too bold, getting punished there. He wanted to see, he thought he had a little bit more time, but JW was not wasting any time at all. Sees, finds JW through the wall, though, and there's Edward through the smoke from CT. It falls apart. Fnatic, once again, it's down to Olafmeister carrying this bomb, but he gets caught behind the coils, and Edward will not let him get away. Na'Vi, three members living as well, secure their sixth round. They can even hang on to that AWP for Guardian. Everything is going Na'Vi's way at this point. They're winning the clutches. They're putting Fnatic in impossible situations.
Yeah, and impossible is the word here. Look at the options Fnatic had going into that bomb site. They get that great opening on Starix, but the Molotov meant they either had to wait for the Molotov to go out or take the challenge by the truck. And if you wait, more backup is going to come in. The odds only are going to stack against you the more you wait. So almost going for the fight is the one thing they could do, or they could try and jump over, but that's basically giving, you know, Seize the free chance to shoot at you. There really weren't a lot of options then. I don't think they had any grenades left either.
Guardian through the smoke picks off JW. Straight down mid, goes for the likely shot towards T-Pit. Just happens that JW, he's standing in the wrong place at the wrong time there. But Edward gives another entry to Na'Vi. Edward up in A apartments, picks up another. That's Flusha down. Krims will bring back and manage to take out Guardian, but Zeus is working his way through. It's turned into a 3-on-3 fairly quickly here, and now Fnatic actually have control of the site. They can get the plant.
And nicely done from Pronax. It's a really important shot going down there, and now, well, that bomb is ticking away inside. They're really close by, and Na'Vi have nothing but defuse kits here, so it's not going to be an issue getting into that one. Down the pits, really strong position. Krims doing some damage. Can they hold the bomb site? They got to hold the bomb site. Olafmeister goes down. Pronax goes down. Krims has to clutch it. It's now a 1-on-2. They got to win this round, but it's going to go down. Na'Vi, can anything stop them right now?
They are dominant. They have the confidence now to walk in and claim kills that they should not get. Krims had the position on Starix there. Starix would have had to push out of the smoke. There's a split second for Krims to catch him as he comes out of there. Na'Vi, or Starix, is going to be blind. And Krims doesn't get the shot. He needed to get that shot right there. That is a big mistake. This is another round where Fnatic, they very well could have taken that. 3-on-3 situation with the smokes on A site. So tough to get in there, but Na'Vi just wade on through. Is it the Swedes? Swedes can't put up a fight.
But they really can't. Seized here, 10-2-2. Top fragging at the moment. That's always a healthy sign for Na'Vi, but this flashbang doesn't work out. Seized is going to pick up one and could have got a second one too. And we're back into another 3-on-3. Zeus already on point here and holding them back with the Molotov. That smoke is going to extinguish it, but Zeus, please, picks up JW.
Yeah, the timing is right there. JW trying to see if he can't spray through the smoke, but Zeus gets him first. And once again, we have man advantage now for Na'Vi moving on into this B site, but Krims returns the favor to Zeus, takes him out, commits deicide, and we're into a 2-on-2, but this bomb needs to get planted here. Fnatic just looking to get a bit more control on this site. If they could get one more pick, turn this into a 2-on-1, it's a very safe plant. But Krims, he needs to actually get down here and do this. They still have a smoke on Olafmeister, but they're gonna use it to block off CT spawn.
Krims is gonna put it down right here, and Edward, not going to take any chances here. Just a bit of a flashbang. Guardian looking for a kill. He's going to take down Krims. And now Olafmeister, again, a 1-on-2 here. He's walking in. He's not looking the right way. And Edward's right there. And Olafmeister couldn't spot him out. These are some painful rounds for the Fnatic lineup to lose because they are so close at all times.
It's coming down to the smallest margins there. Olafmeister really doing the only thing he could do at that point. As soon as that smoke clears on coils, that's when it becomes such a difficult position for Krims to actually get that plant. And he did the best he could. He got behind the fountain like that to block off coils, but he's stuck there because Guardian knows exactly where he's planting. You can't plant anywhere else on that site apart from there if you're hiding from coils. So Guardian just sits there with the AWP, picks him off. Olafmeister has to turn it into a 1v1 at that point. He goes for Edward in the CT spawn, but unfortunately, he predicts that Edward is going to be standing in construction, and that just was not the case. Na'Vi, they're looking like a completely different beast from yesterday in the group phase. You know, the best of ones, they looked a little shaky. I mean, they took second seed, not the first seed we expected of them. But today in this first map on Inferno, it is looking very good for them.
Na'Vi is a tournament team. They're a LAN team. They really are. Like a lot of other teams in this tournament, virtus.pro come to mind as well. They're a team that know exactly when in the tournament to peak. And right now in the quarterfinals, not a bad time to step up your game an extra 10 or 20% and see if they can do this. Flashbang actually on Seize. There's a team flash. So Seize, missed communication going on here, but still looking for the kill and will pick up one more onto JW. And then Seuss chimes in.
This is the difference maker right now. Krims walks in and gets a double kill, but Edward with the spray control, picks up another two. And this is what we're talking about at this point for Fnatic. It's now another 1v2, however. Fnatic, not out of it yet, but Edward, he just goes leaping in, and Edward is gifted another frag. What I was about to say is that at this point, Na'Vi have all of the confidence to be able to take those fights. Seized, he should ideally, you know, if it's still fresh in the round, right, or if Na'Vi are fighting back, you know, he peeks, he sees JW, and he backs off.
Yeah.
But because Seized has the confidence right now that everything, you know, they're so confident they're going to land their shots, he actually stands his ground and wins that duel. And in those kinds of situations, those are things that Fnatic need to avoid or at least come out of ahead. And they just aren't managing it right now. Na'Vi are always keeping that man advantage on CT side.
One guy will buy Banana and everyone else up in second mid here. Flusher will open up and he's going to go down to Starik. So Edward, I don't know, he's still up in the apartments just waiting here for the smoke to disappear. And if it does, he might change his position just because it's too much to cover.
Yeah, sometimes you can't get rushed down from there. So he has to be careful. If they were to double peek that angle, worried about Guardian being up in apartments as well. You know, if they double peek that angle, Edward could get overwhelmed fairly quickly, but he decides to play it safe, back off the pit, just keeping eyes on short. Instead, yeah, you know, Fnatic just overwhelming the apartments right now, and that was good timing there from Edward to back off. Fnatic still making noise quite a bit up here as well, drawing Na'Vi's attention here. But look at the position here from Guardian. He's pushed all the way down Banana, just making sure that there is no way in past this smoke for Fnatic. Fnatic are getting herded onto that A site, and now Na'Vi have rotated the extra man over. Zeus is in library. This is going to be a very solid defense here for Na'Vi.
So will Edward down in the pit. This is the key position. If they kill Edward, they can really take this site. They take down Zeus. Edward's still alive. Starix picks up the one kill. Can they deal with him? They will deal with Starix. And now they should get a bomb plant here. 2-1-3 Fnatic. I think they finally found a way to get in here.
Guardian is gone as well with his flank mission. It's Edward, and this is about as clean as it gets here for Fnatic. Strong defense or not, you need to land the shots, and when you smoke off Edward like that, he can't do anything from that crucial position on pit. So very well played there by Fnatic. That couldn't have gone cleaner for them. That's pretty much that. That's what we need to see more of out of Fnatic right now. You know, less pick play, more just execute. Execute, execute, execute. Go for the strats that you know work 100% of the time, that you've done a billion times in practice. Everybody knows exactly what they need to do, which angle they need to peek, which angle they need to check as they go onto the site. And if Fnatic can keep executing like that, they'll get the confidence to be able to take the fights later on in this half. But it's starting to get into the point where they actually need to get the remaining rounds of this half. They need at least three of the four remaining rounds.
Potential standoff in the middle as JW and Guardian both waiting on either side, but nobody taking a peek. Edward up here is going to get flashed once in the bedroom, and Sue's going to pick off all of Meister, and there's a battle going on between the wall, just shooting through, and nobody connecting with the bullets, and Edward makes it out of there, and they should just play safely now. They got the opening frag, and Fnatic, their economic situation is really bad. They got to win rounds here. They just won the single one, so they got to keep training on.
If they lose this now, it's a calamity. It's not going to go well. Their money will get reset. They'll be back down to 1,400 starting money. And then Na'Vi just run away with this half. Na'Vi could very well finish 13-2 from there. So this is pressure time now for Fnatic. This is a crucial map for this team as well.
That grenade up in apartment does. A little bit of damage to Crims down to 27. But this is going to be a B push coming out, and Na'Vi are in great position to deal with it right here. Crims, that's a huge opening with 27 health. He can actually maybe force a rotation. There's only 25 seconds left. If they buy this, if Crims does his job, they might actually make this work.
Yeah, and now that we see the shift already, Seized his drop back to try and hold from CT. He's going to try and set up the crossfire. Guardian finds the first frag on Crims, though. That's over on the A site. So now all the attention is here on the B site, but Fnatic are getting the frags that they need, and Seized can't stop that plant from going down. If he did, this could have been Na'Vi's round, but now they have to go for the 3-on-3 retake.
And JW holding a great position here. Crims, he did more, much more than he needed to do then. That was so good. Guardian misses the shot, the flick there, and they know where JW is, but they got to check the whole site, and they got to move quick as well. That bomb has been down for a while. It's JW with a kill on Edward. Fnatic finding another round here. I think Guardian's going to pick up one, but there's not enough time left. They got to move quick, seize this alone, and they're at least going to be able to drop JW here. So no AWP save, but that is all for show. Seize going to explode. Finally, Fnatic take care of the fish in that bomb site, and that's going to be 9-3. And this is a really great illustration of it, how much it's not just about the kills. Crims only got one that round, which is the most important frag that Fnatic have had in this game so far.
Yeah, clearing it up. Well,
that forced the rotation. That moved Na'Vi out of the bomb site. They had set up on coils and on oranges.
No, that was C's getting tagged initially that forced him back into CT, taking that damage, changing up his position, and just trying to set up the crossfire there. That was actually really nicely done by Na'Vi not rotating and buying Crims' fake, because they never really made noise from Fnatic. It was only one man making noise on that site. Na'Vi, they're like, okay, we only see one man. Until we see more, we're not really doing anything. So just nerves of steel on Na'Vi's side. But right now it is going to be Fnatic just trying to push up. Na'Vi are the ones who are actually kind of hard pressed for money right now, but Fnatic are as well. They've spent all of their banks. This is a crucial round going into the remainder of this half. Whoever wins this is going to put the other team on eco or at least a force buy.
And it could actually end up with a really good first half here. If they win this and make it back to 9-6, that would be very impressive. And I think that would really, really frustrate Na'Vi. Na'Vi right now are thinking about an 11-4 finish here at worst.
And it's going to be another A play here. Smokes and flashes going in. Fnatic know they've had success so far on this site. They're changing it up. The shots are going through on the smoke, however, and everybody's taking damage. We have yet to see the frag, but Pronax gets dropped, as I call it. All fights are going to clear Guardian out of the pit.
Yeah, walks up here. They're going to take down Seuss as well. Really good comeback. Edward inside just cannot die. He's picked up two kills with the pistol, and now it's a 2-1-2. That bomb will be planted, and Seuss walking in here without backup. He should wait for a teammate.
JW goes for the smoke, and Seuss is taking this fight. He does manage to get the crossfire set up. Starx is down, and this plant is it for Flusha. They're all so low right now, not really sure exactly where Flush is coming from. Starx is going to be exposed. He's looking towards Long. He has no idea, and the plant is not for Flusha. He needs to stop it, and he does at the last second. Flusha, the clutch. 1v2, and he saves his team. Now Na'Vi are in a bit of a pickle. This is not looking good. $2,000, $3,000 on that team. They actually have to eco for the last round, and Fnatic could very well turn this into a 9-6 finish, which would be one hell of a turnaround here at the end of the half for them.
It absolutely would. That would be, I mean, I think 9-6, we're looking at a fairly even situation here on Inferno. Mm-hmm. Even chance for both the pistol round and the second half in that case is going to make a big difference between who wins or loses here on the first map.
Fnatic, I mean, if they get six rounds on the T side versus a team of Na'Vi's caliber, I think they're going to consider that a very fine finish. They're going to be very confident going into the second half at that point. Six rounds is great on the T side of Inferno. If you pick up that pistol, you're looking at 9-9, and then it's anybody's game. So, Fnatic, they just need to keep their cool here and make sure they don't give away too many frags here to Na'Vi, who are egoing. C's did go for a Swag 7, and Edward did invest in Kevlar, but these are just minimal expenses here in this round. Zeus is going to get a great flank on Pronax, but Pronax drops back. Zeus actually peeking out here. Is he going to get a freebie? He very well could. He goes for the shot and misses it. Big opportunity there for Zeus, and he can't come through for his team.
No, that was a very unfortunate misstep there. That should have absolutely been a kill for Zeus there. So that's really something you can't afford to do. Now JW is going to come through and spray down, and Guardian and Seas will fall next. Not saying that the round would have been won if Zeus had got that kill, but he should have got it.
Starks and Edward. Starks does manage to get one frag. At least there's that. Edward is still alive in A apartments. Fnatic have enough bodies on this site, though, to be able to stop him from peeking out. He gets spotted immediately by Pronax, and Pronax is indestructible this round. Zeus takes a crack at him. Edward does, and he lives with 5 HP. But now we go into the 15th round, and what's on the line here is basically Na'Vi 10-5 or Fnatic 9-6. If Na'Vi finish 10-5, they're going to be happy. Five rounds, that's kind of towing the line for Fnatic. If Fnatic can get six rounds, though, they're going to be ecstatic going into the second half.
Yeah, I think either score is going to work for both teams. At this level, it's too hard to predict based on, you know, the one-round difference here. But Fnatic want as much as they can possibly get, and they got to be feeling really good right now. Flusha with a great opening kill. Seize with a good return, though. So quick trade over at the banana, and now they're just going to reset for a while.
They reset, and they should be rotating the man back over to help on A site. We'll see if Fnatic decide to put pressure here early on. That smoke goes down by Guardian, and that's going to delay things here for Fnatic. But Fnatic have been known to flash through on quad and go through to just try and rush down a man like that behind the flash, but doesn't seem like they're willing to risk it at this point. They still have all the nades that they need to go for an A execute, and JW is still here with his AWP. He could go for a bit of a peek. Guardian backs off just in the nick of time here to avoid him. And no, decides to re-peek, and that's going to be it.
And the smart thing about what Fnatic did there, wait a minute, Edward's going to get flashed in here, and he goes down anyway to Olofmeister. A misstep from Edward, and now Seuss is going to take a kill, seized 1-on-3 here. So 9-6 is all of a sudden looking really likely. A couple of mistakes from Na'Vi is all it took for Fnatic to win this. But what they did smartly in the middle of that round, the reason why JW could pick up that kill is because he had his teammates running around. They were making noise in the middle and forcing Guardian to go and take a peek. Mm. He heard them stepping in and Guardian thought, oh, wait a minute, they're walking out now. I'm going to go take a quick look. That was all a mind game from Fnatic.
Yeah, behind that flash, and especially, Guardian is expecting that flash to do the work for him, or to make that safe at least. But JW, not want to miss the shot. Olafmeister, his reaction time there to turn away from that flash in A apartments, though, is just disgusting.
Yeah, but I think that was more Edward. That was like a 80% chance of getting that kill. It was really good that Olafmeister got it around, but that should have been a kill for Edward.
That should have been him going around the corner like that.
Yeah, because, you know, Olafmeister, he didn't get flashed, so that was, you're right, that is really good, but he was still, you know, turned away at like an 80-degree angle away from him. And
Olafmeister following it up with the kill on Zeus to boot. That's where it just falls apart, and Seized is left all by his lonesome. But we're going into the second half now. Seized, he's got his hands clenched, the fingers laced. I mean, now I think the stress is going to start setting in for Na'Vi because they had a terrific start. Seized is still top fragging, 16-4-8.
It should start setting in now, definitely. And what's really cool and what I love about what Fnatic are up to right here is that it isn't just Olafmeister and Krims doing this. JW has actually got himself in this game and are getting some really good kills. And that's such a healthy sign. You can't just leave it up to one or two people. It has to be a team effort. Same thing is true for Na'Vi. They are actually all on the board right here. There's nobody really horribly underperforming at this moment in the game. And that is, you know, that's what you need. At this level, you can't have it be just a four or three-man effort.
No, it definitely needs to be everybody pulling their weight on this team. And now we get to see exactly how Na'Vi decide to play this out on their T side. We know that they're a very slow-paced team, that they love to take their time looking for picks and setting up the big executes going towards A side, towards B side. We have to see what kind of style they're going to choose for, because we've seen Na'Vi pretty much do everything on the T side of this map. Play aggressive, play passive, and rush B site 10 times in a row. So going into this now, this pistol is going to be all important for both of these teams. Fnatic have to weather the storm. We are seconds away from starting the second half here of our first map of the quarterfinals of Gamescom 2014, the second major of the year.
The map picks are Inferno, Dust 2, and Nuke, surprisingly. Nuke is the deciding map, could be a nightmare for Na'Vi. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the show. You've got to watch all day today. We have such a lot of Counter-Strike coming up for you guys here at Gamescom in Cologne, Germany. We'll see. Na'Vi going for a bit of an aggressive push up towards Banana, but as they don't catch anyone, they decide it's not worth it to keep pushing in. We can definitely see it's not worth it at all, Semler.
Oh no, yeah, I know. There is a stack right now, and this is Fnatic risking it, going for gamble, but this is going to work out perfectly. Na'Vi decide to come through, and Krim's getting two. The crossfire is there, and that is absolutely horrendous for Na'Vi. They take the risk. Na'Vi just deciding to bum rush. But Fnatic, that's the gamble, right? They're just crossing their fingers, hoping Na'Vi come through and just decide to rush into B site. And lo and behold, Na'Vi decide to give them a Christmas present early.
And interestingly, this is actually something that Fnatic have been doing for quite a while now in some of the online matches. Mm-hmm. So you would think Na'Vi had maybe that in the back of their mind, but it's hard to judge whether or not Na'Vi then think, oh, they're probably not going to be crazy enough to try it on LAN as well when they've been showing it so much online.
It's just usually, you know, Na'Vi are the ones that they wait. They wait 30 seconds. They wait 40. They wait a minute before they start making any kind of play. For them to just try and catch Fnatic off guard and go in before really investigating the site, holding that angle for 30 seconds to make sure nobody's peeking, I mean, that's really a total change here. Na'Vi, I think, feeling a little bit of the pressure, and it may have got to them there in that round. Hard eco from Na'Vi, however, in this round here. So this could be an early buy. Despite not getting the plan in the last round, Na'Vi could be shaping up for an early buy here.
Yeah, I think you should be right. Flush out with some really good pickoffs with the MP7, getting a lot of money on his side, and it's going to be a third one too. That's like, pretty significant.
What is that, $1,800?
Exactly.
Three frags, it's $600 per SMG kill, apart from the Pro 90, which Olafmeister has gone for here. But Flusha, definitely a lot of bank now. As we can see, he buys nades again, and he's still at $4,700. So that's going to be huge. He could drop an AWP for JW in the next round. He could he can be the bank now for Fnatic. Na'Vi do, in fact, go for that early buy, however. No plants, not many kills, but they still decide to persevere and go ahead with it. And they just want to make sure that they can try and keep pressure on Fnatic. Fnatic, however, going for a bit of a Na'Vi.
Yeah, they're pushing down, but Na'Vi are ready. And actually, Krim still gets a shot through the smoke there. But Na'Vi actually had a setup back on ramp there, just making sure they couldn't get picked off. So that was definitely very fortunate for Krims that he still got the shot through. And now Fnatic, they did what they came to do. They're going to fall back standard play, and that is a smart choice. I think that's a really good idea. 18th round up, and We're looking at probably a 9-9 situation, but it's worse than that because Na'Vi invested into this round. They're going to be ecoing if they don't win it.
Exactly. That's the real risk here from Na'Vi. This is them giving quite a few rounds over to Fnatic and a lot of confidence, a lot of money. I mean, worst case scenario, Na'Vi lose this round without doing any real damage to Fnatic in this one as well, like making them spend some money in the next round buying guns, for example. Na'Vi need to get a lot of kills if they don't actually get this round. But again, we see Na'Vi really going for the patient play here. They still have three smokes, no flashes, so it's all going to come down to the smoke execution and the shots for Na'Vi at this point, because they're not going to be able to blind any of their opponents unless they can manage to get a pick here and run over a corpse. Flusha going to rotate back through library. He wants to make sure that they can't wrap around through Archie. Spots one go past. Can he get the second one, however? Edward gets that frag. Flusha putting shots on him, and it's the dance now between the two. Flusha takes the fight, but Edward with the double kill. Two headshots. And now we're into a 3-on-3. Krims is still alive on the B site, however.
And Krims has been doing so well. Let's see if he can hold it. 9 seconds here. Edward up on the balcony. He's going to take down one or up on that roof right there. That's a triple kill from Edward. And the bomb is down. 2-on-3 retake coming in for Fnatic. They pretty much need to win this. They do not have a lot of money if they lose it. And they have one kid on each player and a couple of flashbangs to do it. Pronax opening up. Edward low on health. Gets taken down. There's another kill. And now it's a 1-on-1. Guardian hiding in the back corner here. Krims seeing if he can find him. He's going to walk out. Guardian is ready. Trying to pre-fire. Guardian picks up the headshot. It's a double kill. And now the gamble in return, Tumla. It works.
It pays off. It pays off in spades. Now Fnatic are the ones in the hole. Fnatic, I mean, Flush's bank has evaporated. They still have Olafmeister on 4,900. He could go for a reasonable buy, but they decide to eco.
And that's shocking to me.
They decide to give the momentum back to Na'Vi.
That's a hard choice for Fnatic to make, and it's on the shoulders of Pronax here. I would have said, let's force it up. We know if we win, they're ecoing.
Look at it this way. They're still on the favorite side of Inferno. They should still be able to chain enough rounds together. If they give one round away, Na'Vi still need to get five on their T side. So that's definitely what's going through Fnatic's mind at this point. They're like, we still have a buffer, guys. We still have a cushion.
Yeah.
We lost that round.
Look,
let's not take a risk.
There's no right or wrong when it comes to choices like this. It's such a hard call, but when it comes to in-game leading, I'm going to put Pronax a little bit higher than myself, I'm going to trust in his choice right here. 19th round is coming up, and we do have 4 C set 75, so it's not like Na'Vi can just ignore this round either. They still have to actually win it.
Exactly, and Fnatic, I mean, they didn't really mess around. It's been quite a while that we've seen all of them nearly going for it. Pronax the only one changing it up, but he goes for the 5-7, and that's equally powerful. But Olafmeister, there you go. Krims, Olafmeister getting two frags. Na'Vi just running in and they get caught in the blender. Na'Vi now need to back off. Bit of hesitation, but guess what? Look at JW's position right now, waiting at top mid. He's waiting for this rotation to come out from Na'Vi. This is very sneaky play. This is what we expect to see from JW. And he's going to start off strong. Picks off Edward and gets another frag. Fnatic strike right back. Na'Vi throw an anti-eco and Fnatic get it perfect.
And it has to be demonstrated to all but the most dense that this CSET 75 is basically utterly out of control.
Unreal. Unreal. Na'Vi not checking that angle. I mean, that's the mistake there, but still, the fact that it's just so good. Fnatic, that was huge, but that was just huge. I mean, we're talking about basically, you know, not forcing it up, and they still win the round, and that's a huge momentum shift here Fnatic's way. As we can see, they get fully bought up. Once again, there is no extra round that Na'Vi managed to pick up.
That round very likely wins the map.
Fnatic can just tear away with it from here, because they're gonna be dealing with an eco round of Na'Vi's.
But it's almost like you'd say, why did they even buy rifles? Why not just stick with the C-set?
All right, well, let's see exactly what Na'Vi can do here, because they've got a couple CZs, they've got the Deagle on Guardian, but on the T side, it's a bit tougher. They have one flash on Guardian. They need to be able to get around an angle here, but JW is holding on short, dancing behind the pillar, making sure that he has eyes on short and Boiler. Meantime, Flusha watching from the other angle. Pronax peeks into apartments, though, and that's one of his patented little pop flashes there. Those are his own. Pronax is one of those guys who will just spend hours on a map figuring out every little pop flash that he can, basically. Every smoke, everything he gets. Yeah. As the in-game leader of Fnatic, he dials everything in. But there's the perfect time for JW to peek, and that's going to be the bomb drop for Na'Vi as well. It's just Pepe Musique from here on out. JW with two, Flusha with one. And Fnatic are going to shred Na'Vi.
Yeah, Edward comes up with a signal kill, but it's not going to be anywhere near enough here. So 10-10 is the scoreline. The game has been equalized, and Krims is still top fragging at 19, closely followed by Edward at 18. We'll have to see if Na'Vi can come back into this, but they're going to have to eco once again. They just don't have the money for it. No bomb plant happening. We're going to have to see if they can walk their way in here and make it work.
Double eco situation. I mean, Fnatic can just run away. Now we actually have the bank on Fnatic as well. After that, you have players at $8,000 on Fnatic's side right now, so it's completely out of control for them. They're going to have such a buffer, and they should have another opportunity here to build that buffer more. Now, Na'Vi, because of that one round, it's totally turned around because they were going to be able to keep pressure on Fnatic. Fnatic, they would get a full buy, but then they would spend all of their money. So if they lost, they got on another eco, and Na'Vi kind of just leapfrogged their way through the rounds to win the first map. Whereas now, Fnatic, it's just hard mode every time. Hard, it's not normal, you know, easy mode beginner, right, where you're just kind of like, okay, I can make some mistakes. Now Fnatic are in the hard beast mode, and you have to deal with them round after round fully bought up.
It's going to require, one of those really upset rounds where one guy gets a quad kill and they win it anyway to put Fnatic out of this comfort zone again. They can't just like slowly try and inch in rounds here. They got to really put them down again. Flusher falling back here and shouldn't be a problem at all. He's up against Glocks and a single CZ, I think. So it's no problem at all for them to pick up the kills. Flusher with a good double going for the triple and he will pick it up again. So 11 to 10 and now 22 rounds into the game. We're going to have to find out if Na'Vi have what it takes. They are buying rifles here. They do have the money for it. And this round is everything.
JW is going to take that rifle into mid. Looks like he doesn't necessarily have the spawn to make the apartment play, but he could actually just peek down mid towards T slope if he wants to. Fnatic just going to be sending two guys over to B. No, three, in fact, over to B, counting on JW to draw the attention. So I do like this change of pace here from Fnatic. Going for a bit of a fight down mid, but there's the flash to stop JW from doing anything at all. If he re-peeks now, it's dangerous.
It definitely is. He does take a tiny bit of damage and still just waiting for someone to come up second mid. If they are going to do that, then he's certainly ready. What I don't like about this is the fact that he hasn't got any backup in the middle here. There's nobody nearby with a rifle that can help him out. That's coming now, but I'm glad that he's falling back.
He makes it around the corner. The smokes go down, and there's no opportunity now really for Na'Vi to retaliate and take advantage of that extra shot. Edward is waiting in boiler, but they aren't going to really give him anything here. He decides to peek on J-Dub after the flash from his teammates. And this is when Na'Vi start getting a little bit of control here. They're really trying to pressure JW, and he's so lucky they didn't peek there, that Zeus didn't round the corner, because JW getting caught on the edge is not going to help things. Sees finds the entry on Krims, and Olafmeister though with a double spray from Arch. And this is now going to crumble for Na'Vi. They're trying to get into B as quickly as possible, and they have the bomb.
Yeah, so they're going to be able to put the bomb down, and it's going to be down for a little while until Fnatic can really muster a good retake here. JW coming up, if he can pick up a kill here, that's almost the retake secured, because it's already a 4-3. Bomb does go down, and who's holding all the way at the bottom of Banana right now? Wow, that's Edward.
No rotation here from Fnatic, however, so Edward, he has to get up to the top of Banana so that he can support his mates. They need to set up the crossfire from Yellow, and Starks managed to pick up two! Now we're into it. Edward is now the last man alive from Banana. He gets the first. JW now has to hope that Edward peeks out, going for the bait.
And Edward, oh, look at this, cold as ice. He doesn't buy it, and JW is out of time. Imagine doing that with $100,000 in first place. You decide not to take it.
And icing on the cake, Fnatic can't hold on to the gun either. JW goes up with that bomb. That was as good as it gets for Na'Vi, but Edward, stone cold.
You do need to have a beard like Edward's to be manly enough to actually stand your ground in that situation.
This is why there's that saying where it's like pros don't fake, right? Because that's what happens. Edward, he's just like, no. JW, he just faked. He's trying to bait me out right now. Edward, what's really crazy is that this is basic CS basically, where if you hear the defuse, you wait 3 to 4 seconds before you peek. You wait 3 seconds and then you peek, you see if he's on the bomb or not.
Great start to this round from Fnatic as Crimson JW revenge themselves and get up to a two-man lead here, making it very hard for Na'Vi to do much of anything now.
Actually, that was a real problem now. JW has a setup towards boiler as well, Na'Vi. It's going to take another play from Starx, another double kill. Seized opportunity, not going to get it. Olafmeister finds him first. Bomb now dropped in T-Pit as well. They are going to get another smoke down, and Edward manages to spray Crims down through the smoke, so that's already a first step, but it's still a 2-on-4 situation here with 45 seconds on the clock. Not a lot of time for Na'Vi to act. And JW finding that pick on Starx. is going to cement things here. Fnatic with a three-man lead. They just have to sit patiently on the sites at this point. I would actually like to see them just rotate a man off of A right now. Get over to B on two. Just put two guys on each site and not allow Edward to have a chance to get onto any of these. Because only one man holding here on Banana. This is a risk. Olafmeister, if he goes down, Edward is capable of finding this kill. Olafmeister manages to make it back around, but then he re-peaks. Playing with fire.
A bit dangerous game being played, but Olafmeister would come out on top. I think you're right, though. If Olafmeister went down immediately and Edward goes in to put the bomb down, he's not going to win the round. But it's more money than Na'Vi need to have. Why not just stop them right there? And Na'Vi are economically completely bankrupt at this moment. They can't really do anything, which means Fnatic could very likely make this 14-11 before Na'Vi can start buying again. And that at that point, I actually think they do have the map. I really think it's hard for Na'Vi to bring it back right now.
Yeah, because, I mean, if Na'Vi need a plant in this round to be able to really get a solid buy in the next, and otherwise it's another situation where Na'Vi, what, double round of eco? That's brutal. That gives so much money to Fnatic, but more importantly, that puts Fnatic at 14 rounds. Do you really allow Fnatic to get up to 14 and then expect to play a perfect T-half from there on out? If anybody's capable of it, Na'Vi certainly are, but that is a high-pressure situation to put yourself into.
I would. Right now, they could buy two AKs and three Galils. They will do that. Yeah. So, yeah, again, it's one of those judgment calls. How are you gonna make it work, basically? I don't know.
Guardian goes straight up. I mean, he has to get the Galil. Very limited nades right now. They have a couple. They still have two smokes, three flashes. Na'Vi can make some sort of play happen here, but Guardian, there's the first smoke going down to block off mid. That's eliminating JW from the picture. Olafmeister and Krims working so well together on that B site. Krims will find Edward first, and this now gets very difficult for Na'Vi. Down a man.
JW also switching it up with his really aggressive apartments play, which he's well known for, but hasn't done so much in this in the second half here, so it might catch them off guard anyway. Starix waiting, and there's a little bit of a patience game going on.
Starix knows. Pronax is now going to back it up, and Pronax is going to be the bait. Starix gets that kill. He turns away. Does he expect JW to be there as well?
CZ 75 is enough to take care of Starix, even missing the orb shot. So now it's a 3-on-4 here. And Fnatic still looking in a very good position at the moment. Flusher's going to peek out into the middle and goes for the kill. Seuss will pick off one, and Flusher with a great kill. And Adolfmeister helping out onto Guardian. So seized 1-on-3, 40 seconds. This is one of those clutch moments where if Seize does it, Na'Vi can bring it back into the game. But if he doesn't, it seems unlikely that they ever will, at least not on this map.
Now, 30 seconds left. Flusher camping the bomb, making sure that Seize can't sneak up. Oh, Seized almost gets that entry, though. Could get it still. He goes for the second spray, but Krims will find it.
That was dangerously close and actually kind of badly played from Fnatic, considering how little time there was left. They could have lost both players, then it would have been a horrible one-on-one.
That would have been a very difficult one-on-one. Sub-14, I mean, he could still try and go for the plant, but there was a teammate waiting in library. And that plant would have been tough to get. Still, Fnatic, they are now on 14 rounds. Na'Vi, because of the early buy, have a broken economy. And they're just trying to mix it up. You can see right now, they're passing around, deciding who's gonna get to have the AK, who's gonna be buying a Kevlar. Two KKs able to be picked up here for Na'Vi. And we see Zeus and Starks are the ones taking the hit, only going for CZs. But this is still full nades for Seized, full nades for Edward. We could still see Na'Vi try and make something here. Fnatic really going for the mass control on Banana, though. Just constant smokes down the bottom of Banana, really hurting Na'Vi towards that A site. And when they get to that A site, Na'Vi are given nothing to work with. As we get into the late game here, Fnatic are really playing it safe. All the way back on the site, only just now peeking up towards short. But even that position played by Pronax is not the hugest risk. He can just float around here, not really expose himself too much.
Na'Vi really put to the test here, and this is Fnatic map pick, so obviously we have DOS 2 coming up next, so I don't think Na'Vi are completely panicking or anything. They did a reasonable job here on Inferno, but Fnatic are good at it. They're really good at it, and it's showing right here. They have a 3-round lead, and the 30 seconds left for Na'Vi, and this is actually much more Na'Vi style, right? Down to the clock, and something they haven't done too much in the second half, actually.
Oh, Starks takes a monster nade to the face. Edward getting roasted at some Molotov, and they're gonna die. Olafmeister with the perfect molly. And this is now going to be the push for B. All three members remaining here for Na'Vi, just rushing onto this site. Seized clears out Krims, but already the rotation has come through from Flusha. 9 seconds left on this clock. He just needs to stop the plant, and he's not gonna do it in time.
But Seas cannot hold this in a one-on-four. They know exactly where he is. He's going to pick up the one kill here, gets a second one, and that's going to be the end, unfortunately. Just too much to handle, even for Seas, who's been doing so well. I mean, he's had 21 kills, and that's not at all bad, but it will be.
Mad typing on Fnatic's side right now. Yeah. They've got quite a bit of communication going on there. We don't see him talking actively, but...
15-11 in favor of Fnatic. Map point for the Swedish team, and we'll have to see if Na'Vi can bring it closer here. I mean, overtime could happen. Fnatic do have a lot of money, so we're talking about Na'Vi winning three rounds in a row, and then Fnatic will eco.
Exactly. This has been the problem ever since that one round where Fnatic came back with the pistols. This has been just a complete and utter turnaround for Fnatic. They have all the money, and it's just going to be the full-out YOLO play here from Na'Vi. Last round of this half, they have to make it happen. They have to get onto this site, but Olafmeister holds, and Crims from Banana, or from Oranges, rather, just shutting them down. We're into a 3-on-4, and so long as Olafmeister stays alive, this is not Na'Vi's site.
Already buying a lot of time here. Really good play from Olafmeister, not showing himself, just waiting as much as he can, and Na'Vi are hoping that someone's going to come and peek so they can get a quick headshot, turn it into a 3-on-3. But I'm not seeing it happening. They don't have any grenades at all. They actually have to rely on Fnatic making a mistake. And up from behind, JW with the one, with the two, with the triple, and it's over. Nicely played from JW. Fnatic picking up the map on Inferno and putting us onto Dust 2. 16-11 victory.
First half played very well in the end by Fnatic, just turning it around, really getting the rounds that they needed at the end of the half, 9-6, and it just gave them the opportunity to get into it in the second half, win a crucial anti-eco, and that's, or an eco round, and that's the big story here, is that, you know, when you win ecos, this is how devastating it can be. Na'Vi never able to recover from there, and the real thing here is that Fnatic just kept their cool, they kept it going, and that was just a fantastic first map to start off the quarterfinals here.
It absolutely was. Very, very impressive. And they win their own map pick. That doesn't always happen. You know, we make it sound like, okay, they pick the map, so they have to win it. We've seen very often that's not the case. But Fnatic got to be feeling confident about that kind of win. Moving on to Dust 2 is actually still, I think, a really even match. I think Na'Vi might have a slight edge, but it's not a huge lead on Dust 2.
My nose, of course, chooses that moment to itch. The problem is that... Well, let's go ahead and hear from it, because we heard that Richard had a couple things to say about Dust 2 earlier. Now, let's see if they can give us a little bit of a preview as to what we can expect on this second map. Back to you, Scoots.
Thank you, guys. We're going to quickly break down what we just saw, and then we're definitely going to jump into a little chit-chat about Dust 2. First point I want to make before we kind of hear your guys' thoughts on the actual matches, yet again, we see Pistol... Eco on that first side, right? And that, you know, I definitely want to get your thoughts on that. It's happening more and more. I can't hear him. We cannot hear our third guy. Stand by, Top Gun. They're afraid of your guns.
I know, man. They've cut him off. They've silenced the Aussie. They knew you were going to get rowdy. That's what it was.
Yeah, no. All right, well, why don't we fix that?
I'll talk for you. I think what my colleague would say here is that the sort of, you know, the CZ is out of control, really. I mean, Anders talked about it a lot during the cast. You are always liable to get eco'd. And what people have been doing is they've been kind of almost playing into their hands. We saw with that round there, I think Fnatic kind of just ran straight into a crossfire after they took that pistol. And, you know, those guns are devastating. Zeus picked up a couple of kills, I think it was. And that's it, round over. It's completely turned on its head. So Fnatic are traditionally slow starters. We saw that at Gfinity, you know, especially in the early games in the morning. They really struggled to sort of get off to a good start. But from there, they lost all the momentum. But they did do enough in that first half at the end by getting the last sort of six rounds.
Okay. Let's just double check it.
Are we back working yet?
No. All right. Let's just do this. We're just going to do this the old school way. Headset off, headset on. Go ahead and give your headset.
All right. Here you go.
Yep. Because we really want to hear from him, Richard. No offense, brother. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, to answer the first question that you did ask me, look, yeah, those echoes, it is tough. And it affects the morale of the team more than anything as opposed to the... Is that for me?
No, we'll give it to Richard.
No worries, all right.
Hand that to Richard. There we go. We'll work through this.
More comfortable with this.
Yep. Beautiful, all right. And you know, it's the morale of the team that it affects more than as opposed to the outcome of the game. And that's what, you know, ultimately could, you know, really affect it. But Fnatic, a top team, you know, reacted well. They lost nine rounds straight in the first half. you know, reacted well, got five in a row again. So they took that momentum into the second half with them. And, you know, it was always going to be a tough task for Na'Vi to win, bring that one back. So, you know, they both played well. You know, big moments in those games. You know, Crims played outstanding, I think. And Fnatic deserved the win, though. They traded well and, you know, stuck to their game plan, didn't let Na'Vi get into the zone. So, you know, got the outcome they were after. So.
All right, so obviously let's move on to the next match, Dust 2. Yep. Yep. Obviously must win for Na'Vi, without a doubt.
Well, look, as I highlighted before in the brief time that we kind of had to go over it, Dust 2 has been an absolute disaster for Fnatic, time and time and time again. Since this team's been formed, they've only won two times on Dust 2. As I said earlier, one of those wins was against NiP. It was a 16-14 at Gfinity, but everybody was beating NiP at that tournament anyway. I don't think we can really read too much into that. And then on top of that, the only other win was in the Star Ladder, and it was against Online Bots, the Estonian team, a 16-1 demo. Fnatic are not comfortable on this map. By contrast, we know that Na'Vi are. They've won four of the last five on Dust 2. They've only lost to Reason, the Danish team, in the Star Ladder, and they've got some pretty prominent wins. You know, they beat I by Power. They've also beat Copenhagen Wolves here.
Yeah, yeah.
We just saw. So I don't know. I think Fnatic are not out of the woods. I mean, they made hard work of their first map. This, for me, has got Na'Vi written all over it. It's a map that plays to their strengths. And I'll tell you something to watch on here. Guardian will dominate that mid area on Dust 2. I don't know if you've ever had the pleasure of playing against him.
No, thankfully not too often. I'd rather not as well. No, you're right. But look, Dust 2 is a good map for both teams, I feel. Na'Vi would be confident, and they need to be to, you know, to obviously take it to a third map. And, you know, I'm sure Fnatic are well aware of what Guardian's capable of with that op on that map especially. So, you know, I'm sure they've got a game plan that could work around it. And again, like I said, I'm a bit biased, but I'm confident Fnatic will unfortunately for the viewers, end the game short. The second, hopefully.
So, keys to victory, shutting down Guardian in that sense.
It's got to be. Right? I mean, more so on Dust 2 than any other map, because this is what he used to do in Source. He did it for years. He would dominate that mid area where he would literally make a pick or tag somebody every time they crossed. He's not as prolific in CSGO because I don't think the game lends itself to that mechanically, but ultimately, his AWPing is just so good on this map. He's done it so many times. And as we know, both aggressively and defensively, the battle of mid is so key.
Okay, and I believe that we've actually got a graphic of this last matchup. So hopefully they'll throw that up on the screen. So we've got this nice stat screen. Awesome. Why don't you go ahead and walk us through this a little bit? We haven't seen this really that much ourselves, so bear with us today, folks. We've got a heat map, and then obviously you got some stats in front of you. So go ahead, Richard, give us a little rundown of this, what you see.
Well, I mean, you can see from here on this, I'm quite surprised actually, because this is one of the things that stats don't really deliver. I thought Crims might have been a little bit higher overall because I thought he was so vitally important to Fnatic. I thought he was the guy who made important kills and really dug deep. But you can see as well that just from looking at how they divided up and went to the various bomb sites, Fnatic really struggled to have some, you know, penetration early on as terrorists. Their CT is impeccable and flawless on that map. They were never going to get too upset about it. But as terrorists, they tried to execute this pick strategy. It didn't really work for them at all. They didn't get a lot of kills, and they were shut down very easily on the site. In fact, the one thing I do want to say before I throw over my genius colleague Top Gun, who'll be able to analyze it more, smokes were so important for Fnatic in there, and again, not really well depicted in the map there. But they won the pistol, predicated on a smoke coming over the top and smoking off a truck, which stopped a crossfire, allowed them to get a quad, won them the pistol round. Okay, so then they get eco'd, but it was 9-1, and they didn't take another pistol round, another win round, a buy round, until they smoked off that pit again and shut down that crossfire between Edward and Guardian. So when they started to execute things tactically, that's when Fnatic came alive. The pick strategy wasn't working, Na'Vi were beating them in 1v1s.
Yeah, absolutely. They almost let them fall into the gameplay that Fnatic wanted to be playing. You know, they were allowed to, you know, they traded very well early, and most in those first, you know, nine gun rounds where they lost, you know, in a row, they were getting the entry frags. They were working the strat that they were trying to. They just couldn't execute, you know, they couldn't finalize, you know, the win for the round for what they needed. And then, as you said, absolutely, they started to, you know, just force the sites, force the strats, stuck to their game plan, made their frags, made it hard for Na'Vi those last, you know, five rounds.
I guess we've got a little clip of the teams like doing their own little strategy talks of each team, so they're going to roll that for us. So they're kind of you know, in between having their nicotine meetings, if you will.
That's incredible. We're actually following them outside now,
yeah,
are we?
It's amazing.
Great stuff, isn't it?
They don't even get a break.
Great stuff.
And again, you could see from both teams, you know, obviously it was a close enough match that they're obviously not yelling and screaming at each other.
No.
They obviously both had some smiles going.
Look, neither of these teams are those kind of people. We saw at the start of this game, they were both laughing, joking around, having fun, both sets of teams. Fnatic are going to be super calm. They've got Devil Walk there as the coach, the calming influence who stands behind them. He's never going to let them get carried away. But equally, Na'Vi, how are they going to get fired up? You know, how are they going to feel the pressure? They've been there, seen it, done it, and the players that they've got who've come into the team, Seized and Guardian, they're really calm, you know. They're not going to get upset about anything. They're not going to get stressed. They know they can win this map. And I think Nuke, the decider, could be a lottery. So yeah, they're definitely not going to get phased. I mean, you've been in this situation a million times, and I remember your team, obviously because you're Aussies, but especially with guys like Boomzer and Tex. You've been in teams that are very volatile and shouting all the time.
Yeah, you know, we like to G each other up, if you will. You know, let them know that we're here, let them know that we mean business. And you know, obviously, it's one thing to be loud and rowdy on your computer chair. It's another thing to take it into game with you. And that's what these players do concentrate more on, and that's what they should. And we had a quick peek of, you know, how what they're like right now outside. They're both very calm, you know, they're enjoying themselves. Both teams were smiling. Na'Vi lost. You wouldn't be able to tell, though, from the looks on their faces. And that's the way they need to be. They can't get down. It's the best of three. Anything can happen. Every round is there for the win. You know, it doesn't matter if they lose ECOs. And these guys are professionals. They're seasoned professionals. They do this day in, day out. They know what they need to do. And, you know, they're out there. They're going to, you know, get back into it. They're going to know what they need to do. They're going to talk their game plan. They're going to get back on stage. And you know, hopefully they're going to please all of us.
All right. As you can see, the guys are now on stage, so they're out
this
of their.
Is great. We've actually got some time to fill. This is brilliant.
Yeah.
I was hoping we get to talk about this. I'm really excited about this too. I think this map is just going to be so open. I think it's going to be, you know, a real exciting map in the series. I definitely fancy Na'Vi to kind of edge it. You know, again, just looking at the numbers in front of me, I think that, you know, Na'Vi have really divided their attentions on the three maps coming into this tournament, the heaviest of which has been Mirage, but the second of which has been Dust2. They play a lot of Dust2. They're very successful on it. They've got incredible strategies. They play off Guardian's picks here. And I just wonder who's going to step up, because we saw in Inferno, JW, who's meant to be the star player, he missed so many shots and got bailed out by, like, Olaf M and Krim so many times.
Absolutely, yeah. And you know, the thing about Dust2 is, you know, both teams, I'm sure, will be happy about the map, you know. Na'Vi more so than Fnatic, I'm sure. Fnatic don't want to play Nuke. Yep. I know that. They don't want to play Nuke. They don't like Nuke. So they want to win this one. And I'm sure, you know, they're not disappointed with the map selection. They know, you know, what to expect from Na'Vi. They've both done their homework. You could see it in that Inferno game. They both knew what to expect. A fantastic CT pistol from Fnatic on CT. Yep. So, you know, or booking, if you will. So they've done their homework. They know what to expect from one another. It's just about getting on the stage and just, you know, feeling it, you know, working for your teammates, working for the crowd.
And that being said, we're ready. So we're going to see Nuke, or we're not going to see Nuke based on Dust2. Once again, Anders and Semler, take it away, friends.
All right, thank you, Scoots. We are about to get into the second map. Excellent time, and this is going to be a crucial map. As was said throughout that break through on the analyst desk, excuse me. As was said there, this is the map that Fnatic want to just come in on, make the statement, get that 2-0 clean finish, because they are a little shaky on Nuke, but if Na'Vi manage to take this back, I mean, it's all over the place, really, really. This is going to come down to a 2-0 win here for Fnatic, I think.
You could be right. That was also part of the prediction going on the analyst desk. I wouldn't be surprised if that happens. Again, I think Na'Vi are slightly favored on this map, but it is so slightly that, you know, this is the problem. If you're talking like 45 to 55% ratio, you know, that only really matters if you're playing 100 games in a row. Yeah, then you'll win 55 of them. Great. But if you're playing just the one right here, that's not going to really make that big of a difference. So I do think there's a good chance that that Na'Vi could end up going home here.
Yeah, I agree completely. Fnatic looks like they'll be starting on the favorite side as well on that T sign, so we'll have to see exactly what they have in store for us. But we can already see JW getting warmed up with the AWP. Guardian, of course, with that AWP. This is the map. That's going to be the Titanic struggle between these two. Who's going to come out in that battle?
But just like on Inferno, I feel like which side you start on is going to matter a little bit less on a map like this.
Sure,
a lot of teams do prefer to start on the CT side anyway. I'm not sure if Na'Vi is necessarily one of them, but either way, I think they're going to be just fine with it. What's really worrying if I was Na'Vi, what I would be scared of is the fact that JW is playing well on Inferno, So if he can hit the shots with the AWP on this map, that means Guardian is not going to have as free a reign. And once it gets to the CT side, it's not just AW, it's Olaf Meister as well.
Exactly. And that's the next point.
That could be pretty frightening. Help. Double AWP setup.
On the T side as well, if it doesn't work out with JW, they go to Olaf. And Olaf is a terrifying AWPer. I mean, when it comes down to between JW and Olaf with the AWP, I think it's neck and neck between the two. JW is taking the primary role for Fnatic, but Olafmeister certainly could step in to fill that role if necessary. If JW feels maybe a lack of confidence or something, Olafmeister can definitely fill in for him. So Na'Vi don't really have that option so much. I mean, Starks is a very capable AWPer, but he never really seemed to be able to find that flow where he just dominated with the gun. It really is Guardian for Na'Vi to look to for that sniper rifle. So we are still in the warm-up phase here, getting everything ready. And both teams, are all in the server right now. So it's just going to be a matter of moments before we get into it. But the crowd is hyped. It's completely filled up here as well in the bleachers. We actually have people waiting outside because we don't have enough seats.
Yeah, look at that. A little bit of clapping going on. Thank you guys for getting up so early to watch all this great Counter-Strike. And it's only going to get better throughout the day. So it's great to see that people come here to Cologne to watch a lot of great Counter-Strike games.
We got the thunder sticks. Bring the thunder. Where's the lightning?
Well, that's going to be in the game somewhere.
But nah, exactly. We're looking to Zeus. Oh, what's up, Pansy? Tossbot's here. Oh, and he's changed shirts today. He's changed shirts. That's it. The Alliance. He's going Cloud9. But I mean, I'm wearing my blue shirt too, so I can't really throw stones. Easy skins, easy life. They made it happen too. What's up, Forrest? That's going to be coming up today later on in our third quarterfinal match of the day between Nip and Cloud9. But it.
Absolutely great. Look, guys, we are just setting up and getting ready with everything in the game and sorting out some keyboard issues. So we're going to go to a really quick break before we get back. Invite your friends, and we'll be back live with the second map here at the first quarterfinal. So stay tuned. Just going to be a second.